Hello, hello, Carmen here. Today we're going to be taking a little bit more of a deeper dive really into efficiency. This is something that it kind of seems like it's something I'm coaching on a lot recently, where a lot of my new students and also private coaching clients are trying to figure out how to be efficient. So they don't have to keep reinventing the wheel. They don't have to keep finding ways to do things correctly, that kind of stuff. So if you have been following me for some time, you know that I'm all about efficiency, efficiency, efficiency. So what I did recently is I had to find another way to be efficient because my schedule is so jam-packed that I'm almost at a point where I have to turn clients away because I just don't have the capability to see them. So I'm going to have to start passing them on to my students or to my graduates. But what I am wanting to talk about today is one of those things that I created or I really sat down and thought about as far as efficiency. How can I get things more efficient? So my therapy appointments, especially that first visit, I used to have to make it longer by 15 or 30 minutes so that I could go over kind of all of the housekeeping things at the beginning of therapy. That was taking so many other appointment times, because if I was really extending an appointment by say 15 minutes, for every time I did that, every two times, that was taking another appointment slot. So it's not a big deal to you if you're just starting out, but when you are like I am and you're slammed and you don't have spots for people, you have to think about, hey, how can I fix this? So what I'm going to talk with you about today is I created what I call a jump into therapy video. So I just did a brainstorm, and there's 12 things that I have written here that I'm gonna briefly touch on. But when I was thinking about creating this video, I created it so it's a YouTube video, and I created it for my clients when they're new, when they're getting ready to start therapy. I have them now watch this video prior to doing that first session with them. And the reason is because it took that extra time that was getting taken out of each of these new appointments. And so I thought about all of the things that were important that I found myself repeating each and every time. And now there's a link for my clients to make sure that they watch this video prior to their first session. So my scheduling system, once they've paid for therapy, I've sent their kit, they're now ready to schedule, take some additional photos once they've gotten their kit, and then they're ready to watch this video. And I require that they watch this video prior to that first session, okay? This video, you guys, turned out to be about 45 minutes long. So while I'm just gonna touch on it, I really went into detail, so it felt like I was giving them adequate information, reasons, examples, anything that I needed to do, okay? So I'm gonna quickly run down these 12 things that I put in my video. So this is something that you can think about. First, the concept of the spot. Each and every one of our clients who are starting therapy, they need to know the concept of the spot, okay? How to locate it, what to do if their tongue is pushing on their teeth, that kind of stuff. So I go over all of that in the video. I give several examples. We talk about that. That way, if they have questions about locating the spot, proper tongue position, that kind of stuff, they can ask me ahead of time, okay? So first is the concept of the spot. The next thing I go over in the video is practice expectations. They're gonna get good results if they do their work. So they know straight up right at the beginning what I expect when I work with somebody, okay? The third thing I go over in the video is awareness. I can teach oral-based exercises all day long, but if somebody doesn't tune in, I always tell clients if the lights are on but nobody's home, they're going to really stall out. They're gonna struggle. They're gonna have trouble, so they have to pay attention. If they're not thinking about their tongue posture, their mouth posture, their nasal breathing, their swallowing, they might have trouble succeeding or moving forward, okay? So that's really, awareness is really, really important. Next, I go over tracking. So I have my clients keep track of certain things, habits, symptoms, Also how well they do with their exercises, what grade they give themselves. So I go over all of that. I discuss the papers, how to use them, everything in that video. Next in the video, I talk about what to expect when they start therapy. If you're already seeing clients, if you're a seasoned pro, you already know this, that you're gonna get those emails where clients are saying, oh my gosh, my jaw hurts, my face hurts, my tongue hurts, my neck hurts, I have headaches. So I go over that with every client in this video, what to expect. I always say that they're gonna hate me before they love me, because it's like starting a new workout. So they're gonna have aches and pains, that kind of stuff. The next thing I talk about is that it's important to do their exercises with passion and purpose. If they're doing something just to get the old check off of their homework sheet, then what's the point, right? So I am very particular with who I work with, but I always stress to them like, hey, you hired me for a reason. You got to bring your A game. So just doing something just to get it done is not going to be as effective as doing it with passion and purpose and making sure that you're doing it correct. If you're looking for an easy way out, if you're finding a way to make something easier, generally that's not what you want, okay? Next, I go over what they should do if they have questions. You guys, my clients come to therapy and they have this many questions. Zero. That's because I never want somebody to sit and have questions. You know, if I see somebody every 2 weeks or if I see them for 3 weeks, I don't want them to sit and wonder if they're doing something right. If they have a question, I want them to reach out. So my clients always know, reach out to me right away. They can text me, they can email me, whatever your preferred form of connection is. But I don't want them to wait for therapy. So ideally my clients never have questions. Okay. But I always, in the video, I talk with them about what to do if they have questions. In the video next, how to make appointments and not to make too many. So we talk about how they schedule their appointments, how they cancel their appointments, how they change their appointments, all of that stuff, because I use a third party scheduling software. I don't handle anybody's appointments. So if somebody needs to change it, they need to do it through that. I go over that in the video. I also don't want them to make too many appointments, because I never know if I'm gonna see them in 2 weeks or 1 week or 4 weeks. It just depends. So I don't want them to make 6 months worth of appointments. Next in the video, I talk about tech trouble. So I see clients all over the world online. And I talk about if they're having tech problems. 5 minutes, we're out, okay? 5 minutes, I have to cancel. I need every minute of every session. So if somebody's having technological problems, 5 minutes, I am going to ask them to reschedule their appointment. It's not the end of the world, but it allows me to be on time for my next client and also to provide the best service for the one that I am trying to see. So technological problems are going to happen. There's times where there's an internet outage. There's times where we just can't connect. Not the end of the world, but by having that in that video, they get to... We talk about it right up front, and so they know what to do if that happens, okay? Next in the video, I talk about the flow of the session. So they know exactly, we're gonna start out with troubleshooting. I'm gonna do skills assessments. They shouldn't have any questions, but if they do, I answer those quickly. Then I teach the new exercises. They demonstrate. We talk about when I want to see them next time. I get their numbers. I tell them what supplies they're going to need, and they're out of there. Okay. So they know from that first initial video, before we even start therapy, what that session flow is going to be like. So they know. Okay. Next I talk about the time frame for sessions. So I see my clients every 1 to 4 weeks. It just depends what program they're in, what their needs are, what phase of therapy we're in. It just really depends. So I go over all of that in the video again, so that before they even start therapy, they have an idea. And then the last thing I talk about, no-shows or late cancels. In my practice, nobody gets a freebie, okay? I plan their therapy based on what program they're in, what they have paid for. And early on, I got tired of being abused, of clients being late, forgetting their appointments, that kind of stuff. So, you know, if it's within 24 hours, they absolutely cannot change it in the system. Sometimes they will email me and say, hey, I can't make it. You know, that costs them a session. So it's your practice. It depends on how you do it. But ultimately, if they know right up front how, you know, 5 minutes in, it's considered late. So if they're trying to connect with me 20 minutes after the fact, not going to happen. Now, sometimes if somebody is 5 minutes late, they will get their cancellation email from me, and then they will try and connect with me on Skype. That's not going to work. And I have had some clients that will say, well, my appointment is 30 minutes long, and so don't I have 25 minutes left? And I just have had to gently tell them that I don't sit in front of my computer and hope that you can come connect. Okay. You got to be on time. You have to be prepared. You've got to have your supplies, or else I can't do the best for you. So, and that's the biggest thing that I've had to get my clients to understand is, if they're 5 minutes late and I cancel their appointment, I'm not sitting in front of my computer. I might have hopped in my car and be driving down the road. I might only have 25 minutes. So my next client, I might be out getting the mail. I might be pottying my dogs, or, you know, having a snack myself. So if they're no-showed, I will always ask them, please make your next session. But it definitely does cost them a session. So sometimes I have to shuffle things around in their therapy. Okay, so that was a lot to go over. So again, just to recap, this video, the Jump Into Therapy training video, or the Jump Into Therapy video that I have every client watch before they're ready, or before they have that first session, I have parents watch it, I have kiddos watch it. A lot of the information is mostly for parents, but I want the kiddos to know also. I want the kiddos to know that they have to do their homework. And again, it just depends also on the age. If I have a four-year-old, obviously beyond the concept of the spot, probably not going to be a lot of information there for a four-year-old. I have found that since I have implemented the requirement of having my clients watch this video prior to our first session of therapy, everybody is on their A game. Nobody has questions. Everybody knows what is expected. And so it's helping my days. Like today, I think I have 14 appointments, 15 appointments. It really helps it go smoothly, and I run on time. When you have that many appointments and they're 15 minutes or 30 minutes or 45 or an hour, it just depends. It just really, really helps. So I thought that would be helpful to share, since I'm all about efficiency, and it seems like this is something that I'm repeating with my clients. So I hope that helps. If you guys have other tips and something else that you're using for efficiency, I would love to know. So I will be back next week, and we'll be diving into something else. So I will see you then.